So we're out with this little mare now. We're down in Stockbridge. I believe this mare's come out of a riding school, and that brings its own problems. They get used to going round and round inside a school and outdoor or indoor, and they learn a routine. And the problem is with that, they bring that same attitude, perhaps, or the same what they know, not their fault, what they understand, to when we train them to harness. So this little baby, she'd sooner just walk along a little trot and like that, which is fine and it's okay, but there are times when you need to get a move on the road. For instance, if you've got a traffic problem and you can see, well, if I just trot up here a little bit faster, I'll be, you know, I won't be in the way on this roadworks or whatever. You know, when they've got roadworks up, for instance, you've got temporary traffic lights, would be a prime example. You need to get through before the cars come the other way. Well, basically, the little mare's got one speed. Walk and a trot. And we'll go all day at a trot, but a trot is extremely slow. And it will come back to a walk on its own, which is a dangerous thing to do. A horse is only the motive power. That's how we should look at it. It's the motive power. It's the engine, in other words. It's the engine in your car. That gives you the power. All other control is done by the driver. So by that, if you want a horse to trot, it needs to trot. If you want it to walk, it needs to walk. If it needs to canter, whatever it needs to do, stop, come left, come right, back up, it's all in your hands as the driver to do. Obviously there's other responsibilities that come with that. It's the fact of not overworking the horse and knowing what it's capable of doing. As a general rule, I would say they're capable of doing far more than people ever think they can. Most horses that come to our yard, in fact I would say 90% or 99% will end up after their period of training will do 14 miles. The reason I say that is Andover town centre is a 7 mile trip out and a 7 mile trip back. We've just been to Stockbridge, for instance, again 6 mile, but if you incorporate the high street is a mile long, so if you go to one end and back down again, you're talking of another 14 miles. So obviously they have a break in the middle, but they'll do that, and they'll do it with comfort and happy. You know, they're not heavy breathing, they're not dripping in sweat. They'll do it. This pony, the time it's taken to come down here, is far more than 60, 80% of ponies of this size and build. In fact, I would say more than that, probably 75%.
Come on, babe.
Now the pony's ready to go home in a very short space of time. He's ready to go home, maybe within the next 4 days, and he's broke and he's safe and he's everything. My problem is that when it's handed back to the owner, will the owner, they'll spend some time with us on picking the horse up, obviously, the pony up, they'll spend some time with us, but they've got to listen, they've got to understand what I'm saying, because this pony will do what it thinks it will. So it'll start making decisions on the public highway or anywhere else it's driven. But right, I'm just going to walk now. I'm not going to trot. I'm going to do this. I'm going to pull over here. And before you know it, it'll be pulling over to the grass verge, eating the grass. It won't want to come out the yard. It'll start doing exactly what it wants to do. And what I'm saying in that, you need to have the horse and look at it in that respect. That's the safest way. Look at it like it's the engine. It doesn't make any decisions. Because once you let it make a decision of whether it's going to trot or walk, the next decision it will be made, it will be deciding when to turn. So that's my problem. Now it's getting that over to the people, because obviously it's it's a quandary. It's a catch 22. You've got to get over to them exactly what's what. They must look at all horses that are driven or ridden. Now, the motive power, everything else that happens is controlled by the rider or driver. This horse can't make a decision, because this horse, make no mistake, will, unless you drive it and control, it will turn round and go home. Now, some people would think, you know, that's laughable. It's laughable until the horse turns round as the car's overtaken it and smashes straight in the side of it. So, can I train it out of it? Yes, I have. It's trained out of it, as you can see. The horse is going where directed. But will the people that own it keep it the same? Will they treat it or look on it, no disrespect to the animal at all, but look on it like the motive power, and everything else is the driver's responsibility? As soon as they let this pony start making decisions, that can be the outcome. Ree's driving at the minute. Now, I know it's crude to tap this pony on the quarters with the reins. And the reason I'm doing that, it's quite possible the owners will do that. The next thing people are going to say to me, well, they should go and have some driving lessons. Certainly they should. I'm not saying that's wrong, and they should know what the right thing to do is. It's crude to use the reins to tap horse. You're also interfering with the steering whilst you're doing that. But in this particular case, this might well be the case. Yeah, that's what will happen. Well, I think if you introduce the whip into their hand as well as the reins at the moment, would not be the wisest of moves. I think one in each hand while they get used to the horse. They have areas where they can be perfectly safe driving it, and once they've got their confidence and they understand what I'm saying, there shouldn't be any problem. You see it going along perfectly happily, you know. But if Ree's driving, and if Ree didn't keep this pony correct at all times, then we would have problems. There's no question or doubt about it. It would stop, turn round, it would cross the road, directly go across the road if it thought we'd eat the grass on the other side. That's what it would do. Because it's had kiddies on its back, going round the riding school, and you know, the little children are not always at the level where they can control the pony, and the pony gets away and takes liberties with the rider. So when people say, I've got one out of a riding school, it'd be bomb-proof. Well, not really, no. One, it's never perhaps been up the public highway, yeah, and seen the lorries and everything else. So you see it going along perfectly happy now. It's only got a rubber bit in its mouth. There's a bouncing slack rein, and the pony's doing exactly what it's told. That's because we've broke it. It's safe, it's confident, it's happy. There's that underlying background that it has, that it thinks it can do whatever it wants when it likes. We've schooled all that out of it. It's taken quite a bit of time to do. And, you know, this, you've got to try and make the people understand that they've got to drive it, not just sit behind it and expect it to make all the decisions. It makes no decisions, only the decisions. All decisions should be made by the driver, as I say, or the rider on horse. It's the motive power, it's what takes us along. I know that sounds disrespectful to the horse. It's not meant in that way, in any way at all. Oh, my horse knows it's going home and it turns left and it knows where it's going, yeah. Any horse will learn anything with repetition. So it'll also learn bad things with repetition. So when they're in a riding school and they put youngsters on there that don't have much experience just to go around for half an hour, they soon learn, you know, to do the least amount possible.
Go on.
And it becomes boring, mundane life, in my opinion. So, we've done our job, the horse does it, the films prove it does everything that's required of it. We're out in the traffic here, no problem whatsoever. But unless they're on the ball, and it will gain great confidence and solace from the person driving it, if the person drives it in the correct manner.
There's a smile on my face every time I hear that sound. The rhythm of the hooves as they touch the ground. And there's no better place I'd rather be than with my safe, confident horse.